The Caribbean island of Trinidad was only separated from mainland South America around 12,000 years ago, when sea levels rose at the end of the last ice age. As a result, it's home to South American mammals that are found nowhere else in the Caribbean. The silky anteater is the world's smallest anteater, only slightly larger than the human hand. Though tiny, these anteaters can eat up to 5,000 ants every night. During the day, the ants have little to fear. Silky anteaters are nocturnal, and in the heat of the sun, sleeping takes precedence. There are larger South American imports on Trinidad too. The island is home to a troop of white-throated capuchin monkeys. Capuchins are found across most of South America and are known for being particularly resourceful. But life on a Caribbean island requires its own special strategies. Trinidad's capuchins have found that the island's coca-like palm trees are a rich source of food. Dead leaves and branches harbor all kinds of insects and grubs. Having a prehensile tail to hang on with means that both hands are kept free for eating and foraging. Trinidad's capuchins have learned to make the most of the rise and fall of the tides. At low tide, freshwater conches are left exposed, sitting targets for an opportunistic monkey. The conch is encased in a rock-solid shell, but the capuchins have found a way to access the meat inside. Lying so close to South America, Trinidad has its own unique legacy of mainland life. For those islands further away, the Caribbean Sea has proved a bigger barrier. But some animals have succeeded in becoming island hoppers. For land-bound animals, the Caribbean's hurricane season can offer opportunities for travel. Strong winds frequently uproot trees, so after a storm, there's lots of vegetation drifting in the sea. These makeshift rafts are one way in which reptiles like the iguana have been able to spread from island to island. The lesser Antillean iguana has successfully colonized many of the eastern Caribbean islands. April brings the mating season, and the females dig burrows in which to lay their eggs. Each dominant male defends a small territory, with up to 7 nesting females. Rivals are deterred from interfering with the harem with a display of aggressive head bobbing. Choosing a sunny nesting site is essential. After digging a burrow and laying up to 18 eggs, the female plays no further role in the care of her offspring. For the next 3 months, the incubation of the eggs will rely entirely on solar power. By June, the eggs are ready to hatch. Iguanas are a Caribbean success story. They've turned the devastation wrought by hurricanes to their advantage, using it to colonize islands that would otherwise be completely out of reach. By early July, the leatherback turtle eggs are also ready to hatch. It's time for the young turtles to leave the safety of their nests on the Caribbean's beaches. The hatchlings emerge in perfect synchrony. Safety in numbers is their best chance of reaching the sea. Over the next decade, the youngsters will increase in size nearly 10,000 times. Even at this young age, the leatherback can propel itself through the water with an efficiency no other turtle can match. Once they take to the sea, the leatherbacks will remain in the mysterious depths of the open ocean for most of their lives. Only the female turtles will ever return to the Caribbean's beaches. Once they're fully grown, they will come ashore to lay their eggs, just as their ancestors have done for the last 100 million years.